What are the practices that build hope and healing and equity in our schools and community organizations, right? And there are just four. The first practice is build practice that supports your own healing and well-being. And that sounds radical, that sounds crazy, right? We're thinking about young people. But if we're not well, young people can't be well. So how are we thinking about having healing circles in our work? I always say that I don't do professional development, I do personal transformation, right? Because we are human in this work, and it affects us as well. The second is to create opportunities to build loving, courageous relationships with young people. We also have to build loving, courageous relationships with ourselves. How do we relate to one another, right? What do we use in our professional development seminars and practices that actually build relationships? The third is to create healing circles that are focused on healing, not conversation circles, right? In the workshop, I suggested that the most powerful thing we can do with young people is to simply tell our story in an honest way, right? To tell our story so that our humanity shows up and not our professional degree, right? When we tell our story in an honest way, it gives young people the permission to do the same. And it establishes a relationship that we can remember and can be leveraged into kind of behaviors that young people, that we want to see from young people. And then the fourth is support young people with creating justice in their communities. That young people can see the inequality. Young people can see how there's an inequality in how terms of resources are spent. And our goal sometimes is to support young people with reimagining their communities and support them with creating options and opportunities to create the kind of communities they want to see. I'd like to end with this quote from Dr. King. And he says that one of the greatest problems of history is that the concepts of love and power have usually been contrasted as opposites. And what is needed is a realization that power without love is reckless and abusive, and that love without power is sentimental and anemic. Power at its best is love implementing the demands of justice. And justice at its best is power correcting everything that stands against love. Go love our children. Thank you.